This lesson covers the t-distribution and how it compares to the normal distribution, as well as a brief look at the student's t-distribution. For large samples, the normal distribution applies. For small samples, the standard deviation is measured in precisely, and the data follow the t-distribution. A t-distribution will approach a normal distribution for a larger n, greater than or equal to 100, but it has fatter tails for a smaller n, less than 100. The t-distribution is very similar to the standard normal distribution. It also has a bell curve, but the standard deviations are computed from the sample data instead of the population. Suppose a simple random sample of size n is drawn from a population whose distribution can be approximated by a normal mu sigma model. When the standard deviation is known, then the sampling model for the mean x is distributed as a normal distribution, with mean x bar and standard deviation sigma divided by the square root of n. When the standard deviation is estimated from the sample standard deviation s, the sampling model follows a t-distribution with degrees of freedom n minus 1. This is the one sample t-statistic. In this figure, both distributions have zero means, but the variances are a bit different. The t-distribution has a lower peak and fatter tails. This concludes our video on t-distributions. Today we covered the t-distribution and showed how it is very similar to the normal distribution. We also briefly showed the student's t-distribution.